This tutorial is a set of videos outlining a number of steps to build a full Spring Boot application featuring a Kotlin service backend, a Java client, and a JavaFX user interface. This second video will show how to create a Reactive Spring Java client that connects to a REST service that's streaming stock prices once a second. We're going to create a new project for this client, since we want to keep the client and server code completely separate as they should run completely independently. This project will have multiple modules in, so we'll start by creating an empty project. Let's call the project Stock Client. By default, IntelliJ IDEA shows the modules section of the project structure dialog when a new empty project is created. We'll add a new module here. This will be a Spring Boot module, so we choose Spring Initializer on the left. We'll use Java 13 for our SDK. We enter the group and artifact details here. Let's call this module Stock Client. We'll enter a useful description for the module so it's clear what the purpose of this code is. We'll keep the defaults of creating a Maven project with Java as the language, but we'll pick Java 11 as the version, as this is the current long-term support version. We can optionally change the default package structure if we wish. We'll pick Spring Boot 2.2.0 RC1 because we'll need some features from this version in later videos of this tutorial. We need to select the Spring Reactive Web Starter, and we're going to select Lombok too. The defaults for module name and location are fine, so we'll keep them as they are. IntelliJ IDEA gets the project from Spring Initializer and sets up the IDE appropriately. For example, it's recognized the project as a Maven project. In the standard project structure, we can see the stock client application that Spring Initializer has created for us. We don't need this for this module, as this module is going to be a library that other applications use. It's not going to be an application in its own right. Instead, let's create a class WebClientStockClient. This is going to use Spring's web client to connect to the stock prices service. One way to drive out the requirements for our client and to see if it actually works is to develop it in a test-driven way. Using Ctrl-Shift-T or Command-Shift-T, we can navigate to the test for a class. We don't have one yet for this class, so let's create one. We're going to use JUnit 5, but IntelliJ IDEA offers a range of testing frameworks to choose from. This is actually going to be an end-to-end test, not a unit test, so let's rename the class using Shift F6 so that it more accurately represents the type of test. Let's generate a test method using Alt and Insert, or Command N. This is not going to be a perfect example of test-driven development, as we're going to create just a single test which looks at only the best case, sometimes called the happy path. We need to create an instance of our web client stock client in order to test it. Let's put this into a variable so we can use it. One of the things we can do with test-driven development is to code against the API we want, instead of testing something we've already created. Let's say we want our client to have a method called prices4, which takes some string that represents the symbol of the stock we want the prices for. We can use Alt and Enter to get IntelliJ IDEA to create this method on WebClientStockClient with the expected signature. We actually want this method to return a flux of stock price objects. The simplest way to create a method that compiles so we can run our test against it is to get this method to return an empty flux. We will build up the real logic later. Now we need to create our stock price class. It's easiest to get IntelliJ IDEA to create the class using Alt and Enter. We can pick which package we want it to go into. Let's just put it into the same package. Here we're going to use Lombok. Using Lombok's data annotation, we can create a data class similar to our Kotlin data class from the first video of this tutorial. By annotating this with data, we only need to define the properties of this class using fields. The getters, setters, equals, hashcode, and toString methods are all provided by Lombok. Use the Lombok IntelliJ IDEA plugin to get code completion and other useful features when working with Lombok. This stock price will have a string symbol, a double price, and a local date time, time, the same as the Kotlin class on the service side. We'll add an all args constructor and a no args constructor via lombok. These are needed for our code and for JSON serialization. If we go back to our client, we can see everything is compiling. Let's navigate back to our test and finish it off. Now we have a flux of prices, we need to check this meets our expectations. If this was connected to a real working service, we'd expect the prices flux not to be null. We'd also expect that if we take 5 items from the flux, that there are actually some items there. We have to use block in this case to wait for our prices. When we run this test, we see that it fails. It fails because the flux has 0 elements in it, because that's what we hard-coded into the client. Let's go back to the client and make the changes needed to connect it to the real service. First, we want to use a web client to connect to the service. We'll create this as a field and add a constructor parameter so that Spring automatically wires this in for us. Now we use the web client to make a GET request. We give it the URI of our service. We know what this was as we put the URI into the browser to test the service when we created it back in the first video. We need to use the given symbol in the URI. Then we need to call retrieve. We need to say how to turn the response of this call into a flux of some type. So we use body to flux and give it our data class stock price. These are the very basic requirements to get a reactive stream from a GET call. But we can also define things like the retry and backoff strategy. Remember that understanding the flow of data from publisher to consumer is an important part of creating a successful reactive application. We can also define what to do when specific exceptions are thrown. As an example, we can say that when we see an I/O exception, we want to log it. We'll use the log4j2 annotation from lombok to give us access to the log, and then log an error. This is not the most robust way to handle errors. This simply shows that we can consider exceptions as a first-class concern in our reactive streams. Going back to our test, we see we now need to give our client a web client. Let's create this as a field in the test. Using smart completion, which is control shift space, IntelliJ IDEA will even suggest the full call to the builder that can create a web client instance. If we needed to, we could use the builder to configure our web client even further. But in our case, we can use the default settings. We want to run our integration test to see if our changes work. But first, we need to make sure the service is up and running. Otherwise, we won't be able to connect to it. We need to go back to the stock service application we created in the first video and start this. Once this is running, we can run the client test. This time the test goes green. And if we look at the output, we can see we're decoding stock price objects with the symbol that we used in the test, random prices, and a time. This is not the most thorough test, so let's add a bit more detail to our assertions to make sure the client really is doing what we expect. Let's change the assertion to require 5 prices when we take 5 prices. And let's make sure that the symbol of one of the stock prices is what we expect. Testing reactive applications is a skill in its own right, and there are much better ways to do it than we've shown in this simple example. However, we have successfully used an integration test to drive the API and functionality of our stock prices client. This client connects to an endpoint that emits server sent events and returns a flux of stock price objects that could be consumed by another service. We'll show how to do this in later videos in this tutorial. Thanks for watching.